Hi, friends. If anybody's here yet, I'm just gonna play guitar while people kind of trickle in. I'm just gonna play some guitar and get a little warmed up. I think we're gonna have some fun today in our homes by ourselves or with our loved ones. Thank you all for coming here today virtually. I see some comments. Hey, chat. It's Hugo and Monique. Hi. Everybody can hear me okay? Voice, guitar, it all works. Sounds awesome. Okay, cool. Thanks, Jose. Looks like we're up to 6 viewers. I'm just gonna do a little background music here while people come and join us. Play Freebird. No. Never say that. I don't know why it's so insulting. It's a great song. It's just, yeah, I guess it's just kind of insane noodling for, what, like 8 minutes? Yeah. And by noodling, I mean soloing virtuosity that I can't do. But I can do this. Yay, Maya's here. Hi, everybody. I assume if Maya's here, King's here too. Hi, King. So as you can see, I'm playing the acoustic guitar today. I've got a few other guitars behind me over here. This is kind of my collection wall. It serves as decor and sort of, you know, it's a little bit of an ego thing. Like, these are all my axes. But I like looking at them as much as I like playing them. So that's why they're on the wall. This one actually took a fall. And even though this is secured now, I don't put it up there anymore because it's got a little bit of a battle scar here. And I want to take extra special care of it. So this guitar lives in its stand on the floor with this. And it's nice and sturdy, and I don't have to worry about it falling and getting hurt more. Because this one's definitely like, it's my baby. I do most of my songwriting on this guitar. I find that acoustic instruments are like the best for songwriting, just because there's less to worry about with having to plug things in, and you can just like just start going and let it flow. I've been doing a lot of songwriting lately, just because, you know, stuck in the house, you want to kind of explore your inner world a little bit, and it's a really good opportunity to kind of dive in. So I've written a couple of new songs. I'm not going to play those here now. I thought what we could do together is look at how like a popular song is made, like what chords, what sort of things do you need to know? And then we could kind of make it our own a little bit. So I'm going to start that off. We're going to learn, I'm not going to tell you what song we're going to learn, but I will tell you that it was written in 1963 and that it was a number one hit on the Billboard charts. Not right when it came out, because a song by the same artists was already number one. So it had to boot out the number one spot before it could reach number one. But this song eventually did get there. So this song is really just made of 4 chords. That's all you really need to make a number one hit, at least in 1963. And I don't think much has changed since then. So those four chords, if anybody's ever taken a guitar lesson, you probably have at least seen these chords before if you don't know them. So this is a G chord. It's kind of the main cowboy chord, like working on the ranch, gonna get some cows today. Like, it's the cowboy chord. The next chord is the D chord, which I don't know. I love the D chord. The D chord is perfect. It's my favorite chord, actually. It's just nice and bright, and it's like you just play these bottom four strings with this sort of claw shape here. And I'm gonna put some tabs in the comments if anybody wants to learn along with us later. You can rewatch this and you can look at the tabs. But so here's a D chord, and you can add this bottom A string to make it really thick and juicy and just like you're proclaiming something amazing. D chords. I love the D chord, like that. And then another chord you can do with this song is the E chord, which is an E minor chord, which is it's a little bit sad, right? That's how you know it's a minor chord, because it doesn't have that sort of like happy sound to it. If you add the happy sound, it becomes a major sound, major chord. But like that, it's minor. And then the fourth chord that we need for this song is the B chord, which is a little bit different. Usually I play it like this, like a power chord. A power chord is made of usually two notes and sometimes a third note like this, and you can move it anywhere you want and it'll sound pretty cool. A lot of rock songs are made from B chords like that. But yeah, I usually play it like that. You can also play it down here. This is actually a B7. A 7 means it's kind of a jazzy sounding chord. It's the dominant chord, so it'll always make you feel like you want to start over. You want to come back to the beginning. But it's actually back to the E there. So those are the four chords you need for this song. And I'll give you another little hint. This song it's by the Beatles. I've shown you the chords that you need. I don't know if I've shown you them in order yet, though, so you probably don't know. Let's see if you can guess the song. I'm gonna play just the intro, and then I want to see people make a guess. It's a Beatles song written in 1963. If you already know what it is, give other people a chance. I'll just play the intro. But the thing is, I can't sing like the Beatles. I don't have the range for it. I'm no Paul McCartney, certainly not a John Lennon. So I have to use this capo. This capo is a thing you use to change the key on a guitar. Guitars are cool because you can really play any key you want without the capo, but this just makes it a lot easier, and it'll keep the same shapes that we just learned. So I've got the G chord up here, I've got the D, and we've got the E and the B. The B right there. So let's take a look at that intro and let's see if anybody can guess what song I'm about to play. All right, here we go. One, two, three, four. And then I'm gonna start singing, but I'm gonna give you all just a second to guess. Any guesses? There could be a prize. I'll have to figure that out. And then words. King found the emojis. Any guesses? I'm gonna give you like 10 seconds. Anybody? Nothing yet? All right. Well, the answer is "I Want to Hold Your Hand" by the Beatles, of course, right? Now that you know. And probably one of the reasons nobody got it is because we changed the key. There's a lot lot of guesses popping up now. Yeah, there's a little bit of a delay, so I couldn't see your guesses right when they showed up. But yeah, it's "I Want to Hold Your Hand" by the Beatles, and it's a classic song. Changing the key totally changes the song, because, you know, it's this melody that we've heard over and over, and I'm changing, since my voice is much lower than Paul McCartney's and John Lennon's, who sing in harmony for the whole song. I changed the key so that I could drop it down an octave and sing it without kind of squeaking at you the whole time. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to sing without squeaking at you the whole time, but I need some coffee first. Sweet caffeinated beverage. It's actually not sweet at all, but it's what I need right now. All right, so here we go. Sorry, I got to start over because I forgot to tell you, I'm making this a special quarantine version of "I Want to Hold Your Hand." It's called "Don't Want to Hold Your Hand" right now. And it's just a little bit of a reminder, like, you know, let's keep our hygiene in mind. Here we go. Staying home if you can, and please say to me, don't wanna hold your hand, don't let me hold your hand, don't wanna hold your hand. And when I touch you, I feel germy inside. It's just a feeling that I must sanitize, sanitize, sanitize. Yeah, you might have that something. I think you'll understand when I say that something. Don't wanna hold your hand. Don't wanna hold your hand. Don't wanna hold your hand. Not right now. Don't wanna hold. All right. Thanks, everybody. That was a special quarantine version of "I Want to Hold Your Hand." Just a reminder, it's still okay to hold people's hands if you live with them, if you love them, but don't hold random strangers' hands, and make sure you wash those hands and stay home if you can. I really want to thank everybody for joining us on Friendly House's channel. We're trying to keep the community involved and connected as much as we can. Just kind of doing live streams and giving people a reason to come together virtually since we can't do it in person. So thank you for joining me for Let's Play Guitar today. We have a few other live streams coming up. Our friend Gabby Portuguese Hendrix is doing some exercise classes online today. It won't be on Facebook Live, so I'm going to put the Zoom. It's a video conference called Zoom. I'm going to put the Zoom link in the description or in the comments below. And I'll also make sure to put the tabs and the words for our new song here. And then on Monday, our friend Sandra Marianne Oberdorfer is going to do some story time, and it's going to be awesome. So tune in to Facebook Live on Monday and Zoom today for some exercise from Gabby. Thank you all once again for being here, and stay healthy, stay safe. We'll see you next time.